Okay, let's code the Google UMP SDK GDPR into our game application. This doesn't yet have it. So we need to have the Google Ads GMS Play Services, the latest version 22.2.0. Now this has built in the UMP consent SDK. If you don't use this, go into the link that I supplied at the start of the video and get that SDK implementation directly to get the UMP SDK. Okay, now we're gonna need to create a new package. Let's call this GDPR consent. Okay, now in here we need two classes, but at first we will create the Google SDK for the consent. So I call it my GDPR. Okay, it's gonna need to have context. Like so. And it's gonna need to have some support functions. These are standard functions built in into the Android, so I'll be just using them. You know what Toast is, so that is what I'm just preparing here. And I'm using scope main dispatchers.main because Toast need to be shown in launched in a main thread. Okay, we want to have a tag so we can tag IGDPR. Like so. And what else do we need to have? Okay, logging. I'm just gonna take a shortcut in here. So you can use the standard logging. So I have my custom logging class in here. Then we will create the first two UMP classes that we will need. So we will need to have consent information. Is user messaging platform. Now this is the UMP, part of the UMP SDK. And get consent information with a context. Okay, we'll be using that. Then we want to create a consent form. Consent form is something we can use as an instance to show the create and show the form. So consent form is, this needs to be nullable. Consent form is null because it might exist or might not, and we need to create it if it doesn't yet exist. So okay, it seems that we can code the main functions of the UMP SDK. So first, let's create a function that is we can use to call this SDK from the main activity. So this is going to be public update consent info. We need to pass in a couple attributes from the main activity. There, we don't have a view model in this game, and we don't yet have consent tracker, but we will need it. So let's create consent tracker class in here. This is gonna be the community-based solution to actually know the true state if user fully consented or not. So let's create consent tracker class in. Here it's gonna need to have context also. So we don't need to fill this yet, we just needed it to exist. And by the way, while passing in the context, pass in the context from the main activity at onCreate, or use the app module coin to get the application context without causing memory leaks. So let me just check in here. I wanna know that what did I use in app modules? Yep, also the consent tracker will be fetched from the coin. I'm just preparing these instances in the coin app modules like so. So we can use them through the coin. Mm-hmm. Okay, now we can code the first function. A second. Okay. So we need to create params is consent request parameters. Okay. Dot builder. And we need to have set consent for underaged. I'm using false. This app, my apps, any of them are not meant for underage kids. And we can say build. So this is for production params. There's gonna be a little differences while we are debugging this. Okay, then we need to create a function to request consent info update. So I'm just copy paste this. We don't have the function yet, but I'm just passing it in here. No view model in this app. And we should be able to create the function like so. Okay. I'm just preparing this in here. Now we want to call this, pass in the params, pass in the activity. This is gonna be the main activity that we call this function. Once we have the params, we call this, and we also have init adds a lambda function in here and our consent tracker to know the detailed status. Okay, and we are good to continue to code request consent info update. Okay, now we can request the consent info update. We'll be using our consent information class to request consent info update. It needs to have activity passed in, and it needs to have the parameters passed in, and then there's gonna be two callback listener functions for success and an error. There's gonna be form error, which pretty much we will log. So you can use any logging method in here. I'm just gonna be using my custom logger to get the update, the error in here. Then we actually will check if the consent is available. So I take some comments from my previous application and we will say if consent information is consent form available. So in the add mob, of course, if you've created, it will be available. And if the application user is in the GDPR area, meaning his UK or European resident, it will be available. And now we need to have a function to, let's call it load they copy paste in here, and we make a function called load form. We pass in our activity consent tracker and our lambda function to initialize ads. So now we have this function in here. I'm just gonna set it up ready for us like so, and we need to make an else. If there's no consent form, I just say in here to do check from consent tracker, to do check status, actual status from consent tracker. So always when we are in the state of hesitation, we want to use the consent tracker. Consent tracker actually holds the detailed data how user consented and is he in the GDPR or not. So I always fall back into the conclusion of the consent tracker. Actually, let's take the consent tracker now from